'Twas the night before Armageddon, and all through the house, every creature was celebrating, even the mouse. Autographed pictures of televangelist hung by the chimney while dreary end time songs were sung. "It's the end, it's the end," Tapley cried out with glee, as he banged on his keyboard and sang out of key. He put his own lyrics to old Christmas tunes, but what did he care? 'Twould all be over soon. The night sky seethed with mysterious form, apparently brewing one hell of a storm. Mr. Tapley sang louder, his face turning red, while visions of Antichrist danced in his head. "It's prophesied," Tapley sang out with joy, while banging the keys of his musical toy. Then he switched off his synth, his singing complete, and lit a few candles, and then took a seat. He opened his Bible and unzipped his pants. His eyes were now shut, as if under some trance. Suddenly, he engaged in frantic masturbation, with his Bible propped open to the Book of Revelation. With a hand on his rod and a thumb up his rear, Mr. Tapley could tell that the end was quite near. So he searched through the scriptures by dim candlelight and throttled his poultry on into the night. When outside the house there arose such a clatter, giant peals of loud thunder made Tapley's teeth chatter. His chair started bouncing, the whole house shook. He postponed his pud-pounding to go have a look. Through the window he watched while bright flashes of light carved insidious shadows forged from pure fright. Then suddenly he noticed, right there on the grounds, a massive sleigh pulled by vicious hellhounds. With an impish driver so dark and so quick, Tapley knew right away that it must be Old Nick. His dog demons howled and snapped at the air. Old Nick cracked a whip and yelled out with a swear.
"God damn it, Abaddon, and Satyr, and Garion, Abagor, Nurgle, Samael, and Legion! To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall! Now slash away, kill away, destroy them all!"
So up to the housetop the hellhounds flew, with a sleigh full of suffering and tribulations too. On the roof, Tapley heard as they strained at their leash the scratching and clawing of Lucifer's beasts. But before Mr. Tapley could get turned around, down the chimney crept Satan with hardly a sound. His breath smelled of brimstone, his eyes were ablaze, and he stared right at Tapley for what might have been days. His face was thin and sunken in, and a two-pronged beard crept across his pointy chin. Behind his thin lips were fangs of yellow. Mr. Tapley grew faint to see such a fellow. With nipple clamps, leather, and boots of some size, he sported tattoos spreading over both thighs, a mask with a zipper, with holes for his horns, and a gimp for a pet whose hair had been shorn. At his feet scurried four grotesque, demon-esque creatures, with faces erased and devoid of all features. Nearby, a black sack labeled 666 was writhing and churning, making Tapley quite sick. With a sudden whip crack, the demons made their attack, and poor Mr. Tapley was soon flat on his back. Held firmly in place, each demon took a seat, one on each hand and two on his feet. Satan spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and flung open his blasphemous bag with a jerk. The sack spilled open and nightmares oozed out. That the end had now come, Tapley had not a doubt. Crusty crab creatures with fishhooks for arms swarmed over Tapley and showed him their charms. Rusty hooks tearing his flesh as he screamed, and like a proud father, Satan looked on and beamed. A thousand more terrors slinked toward Mr. Tapley, to get more acquainted, to put it quite aptly. Some inched up his legs, and some up his nose. Some crawled in his ears and played tiny banjos. Then out from the sack crawled a thing so obscene, Tapley grew nauseated and tossed his cuisine. Its skin opened sores, and on its head like a spire grew a penis-shaped horn wrapped in prickly barbed wire. Without advance notice, it rammed Tapley hard and shredded his trousers with blatant disregard. Tapley screamed and cried, "Please don't stop!" Making Satan's eyes bulge and his bearded jaw drop. In disgust, Satan yelled out,
"That's it! I quit! I can't believe Tapley's enjoying this shit!"
So taking his toys and his demon friends too, Satan flipped him the bird, and up the chimney they flew. On the roof, Tapley heard the hellish team taking flight to spread wicked evils and propagate blight. But he heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight,
"Armageddon to all, except for you, Mr. Tapley!"